Ah, yes. Code Vein, the stinky poo-poo game of the Dark Souls series. Hello, everyone, the Duke here, and today, I've got a bit of a rant for you. I really don't like Dark Souls. I mean, wait, I really like Dark Souls. It makes me mad sometimes, but I really don't care for Code Vein. Let's go into the things I like about this game, and that is the user interface, the menu system, and the upgrade system. These are all very well laid out, and they look good, but they're easy to understand. I mean, that's the perfect medium to achieve. There's obviously a lot of thought that was put behind their decisions, and it shows. The upgrade system is also much easier than Dark Souls. Instead of having all these little sliders to adjust, you just simply upgrade all your skills, and then you can choose a different blood code, which is your fighting style. Another thing is the character creator. It's actually nice to have a competent character creator, because let's be honest, the Dark Souls one is really only used to create abominations, and you really don't even see it because you always got a helmet on. I mean, obviously the peak of this is having turtlenecks in the game, but I'm getting off topic. Unfortunately. That's literally everything I like about this game. Let's talk about art style. This game has a very bizarre one. The enemies, I don't know how to describe it, except they're terrible to me. I mean, what is this thing supposed to be? An average shopper at Walmart? I really don't get it. It doesn't look good. They aren't cool to me. I do not vibe with this. Your character looks cool, and so do the other ones, but they feel really out of place. I mean, in a modern setting, they're using these giant swords and muskets, which is cool. The thing is, it's revealed that, of course, there were soldiers with guns that were fighting against, I think, vampires or whatever. And so I'm like, what happened to them? You know, why are we doing this instead of that? And it feels like they just were like, oh, this is the way it is because, I mean, if it was an 18th century or a medieval setting, it would fit so much better. It takes you out of the world. Like in Dark Souls, sure, you can be having a massive sword, but it makes sense. There's creatures with massive swords. You're in a fantasy medieval land. Even the wild sets of armors and the enemies fit the setting. They match the environment, and it allows you to connect with the world, to sort of understand it. But in here, you're so different, and everything else is so different, that there is no connection there. You're completely disconnected from the world, and that's one of the reasons I could care less when I was exploring things. I mean, yeah, this area should be cool, but there's nothing about it that makes me feel like I want to explore it. In Dark Souls, oh, look at this giant library. There could be forbidden knowledge in here. What secrets lie? But here, oh, I'm wandering around in a parking garage. Look, that person probably double parked, and that's why their car was crushed. Oh, look at here, in an abandoned city. Chicago, how lovely. There's like three color palettes for this game. Brown, piss yellow, and blue. And none of them really look that good. This world is really boring. It's just concrete and sand and snow. The absolute blandness of everything mellows you out, and, well, the parts that are supposedly interesting, or I guess they look unique to say the least, feel like some of the worst design levels in my opinion. That brings me to another point I dislike about this game, and that is the difference between a hard and a difficult game. Now, this may be a little confusing, it probably is, but a hard game, let's take a first-person shooter. You're behind cover and you stand up. Instantly, all the enemies in the area zero in on your head, and they fire a million shots, and before you can even squeeze the trigger, you are dead. You've been completely blown up, and yeah, that's hard, but there's nothing satisfying about that. A difficult game would be, you stand up from cover, a few of the enemies spot you, and call reinforcements. They try to start flanking you, they're keeping you under fire, you have time to shoot, but you have to be careful, you have to think. Essentially, a hard game is one that just makes things annoying for you because, oh, annoying equals good. While a difficult game requires you to consider things, and while it may take a lot of brain power, it's very satisfying when you figure it out or defeat the boss, for instance. This hard style of thinking is especially apparent in the Cathedral level, which is by far the worst level I've ever played in any game ever. I actually quit the game originally when I was playing it in 2019. I got to this area and I realized what it was, and I went on hiatus until recently when I decided to get my money's worth, which it wasn't worth playing it, I'll let you know. This and many other levels are confusing. They're intentionally designed to trip you up, to have it where, oh, I'm climbing up these stairs, I wonder if there's a hole at the top. Oh, psych, there was. It's not even fun, it just pisses you off. And Dao, Dark Souls has confusing levels, but there's a method to the madness. There's a design to it. You can figure it out. This one is just completely and utterly random, and I mean, I got no idea what the people were on when they made these levels, but it was something. Combat-wise, it's not that bad. It's pretty fast-paced, and I like how you can have these quick access keys to do all these abilities, but the thing is that the enemies, well, They're the same ones throughout the entire game. There's like four different designs, and yeah, a couple areas have some unique ones, but you fight the exact same ones all throughout the game. I mean, it just feels so lazy. The bosses are okay, but none of them really stand out, and I've also never had a Dark Souls game, minus Sekiro, but that was a strange one, where I went in completely blind, having not played the game for 2 years, and I defeated two bosses in a row without any care in the world, and then I just absolutely got curb stomped by several others. The difficulty is really weird with them, especially this boss fight, which is, there's plenty of videos online about how horrible it is. It's the pinnacle of this game's lazy design. I mean, they got all the stuff in the background, like the UI, the menu system, the graphics look good, the character creator, the weapon upgrades, everything except the combat and the levels and story and everything else. It's like they just completely gave up on that and just like, throw it together. Oh yeah, and if you're wondering about the story, you're the chosen one. You have all these special abilities, there is no challenge. It's not like Dark Souls where it's like, hey, there's this legend and you might live up to it, but you're probably going to fail like the thousands before you. It's, no, you have all these abilities, you're a magical boy, go and defeat the world. The sound design during cutscenes is atrocious. The way they reveal the story is essentially a walking simulator where you do absolutely nothing except look at something that's somewhat cool, but ultimately very boring. And because you do it so many times, it really loses its appeal. Lastly, one of the things that really bothers me about this game is the co-op system. Now, you can have an AI partner with you throughout the whole game. Before bosses, after bosses, during bosses, the whole thing. Now, the game also has the sort of Dark Souls style co-op, where before a boss, you can invite a player into your session, you can fight the boss together, and then after the boss is defeated, they disappear. And the thing about this is, why can't I have a player with me the whole time? I can have an AI, which sometimes is overpowered and sometimes is completely stupid. Why can't I have a player with me? Because if this game was co-op, that would honestly make it so much better. It's such a bizarre design because, as far as I know, the Dark Souls games prior had a peer-to-peer system, which means there's no server, so it's extremely cheap to have. Now, if it does have a server, they need to really fix that because that server sucks, but a peer-to-peer system would allow you to play with someone throughout the whole time, and I don't care if it's laggy, just let me play with a friend. A co-op Dark Souls game is a really cool idea, but they completely skipped this because, you know, in the spirit of this game, they were lazy. It's not necessarily that this game is terrible. A lot of people like it, and you know, if you enjoyed this game, that's great. The thing is, I had so much hype, I was really looking forward to it. I had just finished up Dark Souls 3 for like the 10th time and was starting to get burned out, and I was really eager for a new adventure. And it turned out to be very disappointing. Unlike a bad game, which can sort of be redeemed by making fun of the bugs or jankiness, with a game that you're disappointed by, you can't ever return to it without that feeling of just, wow, I wasted my money on this and all that energy looking forward to it. What a disappointment, really. I know this isn't in the style of my usual videos, but I kind of wanted to try something different and, well, I was deleting some Code Vein footage and wanted to show people how much I disliked it. Oh yeah, I forgot. There's this song called Underworld by Vamps that plays during a cutscene. It's really cool, and I think that's one of the only things I really liked about this game. I hope you've enjoyed the video, and this has been the Duke, signing off.